You know, the difference between parallel and series. This is series connection, to put it beside. And this is the parallel connection, I'm to put it to parallel to R. Okay. Now what these steps? Actually same steps. Same steps. When I connect my circuit, I will do the same steps. Here, I in milliampere and get V. 2, 4, 6, 8, 10. And give me how much V here. Okay? Plot between I and 10 to minus 3 ampere and V in volt. You will get that like this relation. Give me this slope. And the R calculated is equal what? Is equal the slope in R. Now what's the R expected? In series connection, R expected is R1 plus R2. R1 plus R2. So R expected, this is actually from the Ohm's law. From where I got that R, equivalent R is R1 plus R2. When I apply the Ohm's law, I'm getting this one. I'm getting this. Did I prove the Ohm's law? Yes, I proved it because the relation between V and I is linear relation. Okay, how I get R calculated? From this law. Okay, what's the R expected? It's R1 plus
R2.
R1 how much? 470, R2 330, so this is giving me 800 ohm. Okay, and give me the percentage. How much? By applying this equation for that section. Clear?
Yes.
Okay, in parallel. Same thing. You see, this is I in milliampere. This is V in volt. Here I have 2, 4, 6, 8, 10. And give me how much voltage for each reading. And then plot between I 10 to minus 3 ampere and V in volt. You will get like this relation, so you prove the Ohm's law and give me the slope for that. So R calculated is equal what?
No.
Is equal the slope. R calculated always equal the equivalent resistance for the circuit. That's why equal to the slope of the relation between I and V. R expected is equal what? In parallel connection,
1 over R,
one over R, yes, is equal 1 over R1 plus 1 over R2. If I take this is to minus 1 and this is to minus 1, reciprocal, so I will get what? R is equal 1 over R1 plus 1 over R2 to the power minus 1. So actually R expected is equal this. Okay? So here R expected is equal 1 for R1 plus 1 over R2 to the power minus 1, and when you apply it, you will get about 139 ohm. Okay?
Yes.
So this is expected value, also give me the percentage. Error. How much? Now pay attention here, because this is a very important point. Here in this section, please leave your pencils. Just pay attention, because this is very important in your discussion. Here I can accept error, percentage error, until 5%. Here I can accept error until 10%. Why? Because I have two resistors. Each resistor gives me 5% error, so I can accept until what? Until 10%. Is that clear? Because I am using two things, and each one have 5% error, so this is the summation of this about 10%. So here I can accept percentage error until 5%, here I can accept percentage error until 10%, and here 10%. If I am using 3 resistors, so I will accept until 15%. 4 resistors, because each resistor give me 5% error in reading. Clear? If you are here below 5%, and here below 10%, and here below 10%, so your job is perfect. Okay? Now, what's the procedure? Actually, this is the law. This is the theory. General theory. We have the circuit. Procedure. First, connect for each part. This. Connect your circuit. Two. Change I and find V volt. I mean I here will be 2, 4, 6, 8, 10 milliampere. 3. Tabulate your data and plot V versus I. I mean, this is the tabulate your data and plot this plot. Okay? 4. Find this one. 5. R calculated for each part. R calculated is equal to what? Is equal to this one. And this is it. 6. Find the R expected for each part. Okay. 7. Find the percentage error. How much for each part? 8. Discuss your results. This is in the discussion. Okay, this is the procedure. What we call the, you should put the, some procedure in your report. This is the procedure. Clear?
For each experiment,
for each, for each part, I have these steps. Okay? For each part, I have these steps.